Yeah, Smart War Games here. When looking for ways to digitally play board games, be it a solitaire or multiplayer on your PC, yeah, there's names coming up like a Vasal Tabletop Simulator, but also another one, Shunzu, which is also a software allowing you to play a lot of board games, including, of course, also war games on your PC. And yeah, I see Mojo's being developed for it to this very day and people using it to this very day. I usually used Vasal and Tabletop Simulators in some instances. So let's give it a try, and yeah, I will show you where you can get it, what are the main differences, and where you might find your favorite module. So yeah, it has own a webpage, and at least according to the webpage, it is not being that actively developed anymore. Since what you could say, almost, yeah, 10 years. That seems that was the last time then that this was developed. Now you might ask, yeah, I know Vasal, I saw it on your channel, you used it here several times, even preparing a new Vasal video. Why Shunzu? Well, there's some differences, while Vasal is rather a Windows interface, yeah, Shunzu is trying to focus more on immersion, trying to re-give you the board game experience that you're sitting on a table. That is not really usually what you have with Vasal. Yeah. It doesn't feel like you're sitting at a table. It is more interface focused, more clear vision, which can also be an advantage. Yeah. If you, for example, also compare Vasal against Tabletop Simulator, yeah, Vasal has usually this clear from top-down view. Yeah, and while Tabletop Simulator is more this, I'm sitting on the table. So I think also this, because you're mentioning Tabletop Simulator, I think this was released before Tabletop Simulator became a thing. Nowadays, Tabletop Simulator is also quite popular. When it comes to war games, might be hard to find many of them there. That is a given. And yeah, I think Shunzu, I will show it to you, I have a module loaded up which you can directly compare on my channel, is giving you this tabletop experience. Yeah, I would go call it tabletop liked or tabletop simulator liked. Yeah, A, it is free. You can download it here from the file section. And B, it is not that heavyweight like Tabletop Simulator. Yeah. From the button amount, from the hotkeys, etc. Yeah, and it is more an all-in-one solution, or was meant for that. It has built-in voice communication. In Vasal, you require something like Discord or what else. I don't think that is really a big advantage, but I can't judge by myself. Yeah, for me, a lot of stuff is easy and obvious, and I know others, they struggle even to install, I don't know, Open Paint, or even browse to their hard drives. So, of course, if you're not that affine to computer games, which is probably true for some that are focused on board games and want to play it on their computers for whatever reason, perhaps because they don't have the room for the, or they want to store their games without always keeping the board around, but they're not that much into computers, that can be, of course, a big advantage when you have video conferencing and voice communications built in. Good, yeah, that is big differences. It is more 3D, yeah, you will see it. I mean, we can already load a module, but let's first finish the webpage section. Yeah, about modules, there might be more resources, but here, for example, if you, download, let's quickly finish that. Download is easy. A download, you get one file, And it seems to be an executable all in one. Not sure if it is installing somewhat on your PC. If it is doing that, I don't like that. Let me select a folder, but it seems to be one file. And you double click on it and it launches. And one big thing to keep in mind is it seems Shunsu only runs on Windows. Yeah, that is perhaps a big thing. And perhaps only on modern Windows. Yeah, so if you use other software like, I don't know, Linux, OS, Mac OS or whatever, no, I'm just while researching found out that this is focusing on Windows. Yeah, and comes in some different languages, okay, if you require that. I guess that is not real difference. And yeah, there's a built-in editor which you can use in order to import your own. I guess that's how people use it and still make modules for that, as they for some reason, some of the stated reasons prefer this here and keep continuing building it. Yeah, but Vazal is still being developed and this here could be it is still developed, perhaps as, but yeah, I mean, last update 2012 here, at least on the official page. Exactly, here below files, yeah, you can check for games and you will find a good amount here. Yeah, and you see the forum is still quite active. Most stuff is, or most sections received posts days, weeks ago. I found another page, I put it into the description where you can also find a lot of Shunsu games. Let's see this further amount. It is definitely not coming with this big variety than like Vazal. Many modules you will find on both Vazal and Shunsu. There might be also some games that you only find on this here. So yeah, check it out. And then you go into the program, yeah, that is here hidden. There's a menu, which then you can use to load a module. We will load a module we already used in Vazal, so you have a direct comparison. You can look on my channel, I played The Hunters, that is a submarine solitaire war game. And you will see if you're a bit used to Tabletop Simulator, it is quite indeed looking a bit like Tabletop Simulator, yeah. So, and you see the screen stuff is very. One thing, of course, is you can't open multiple screens. That is, of course, a big advantage, I mean, of Vazal that you can set up your screen. But one thing, for example, that is here usually better. Yeah, and maps and counters. Yeah, I guess you can set here something. And exactly. So, yeah, there's also distance measuring, okay. Yeah, and right click is zooming in. And it is indeed like a clean, light tabletop simulator. Yeah. Very fast. No, but not that, as I mentioned, not that heavy like tabletop simulator. Very clean, very streamlined. Rotate my map, or is that only? No, we are not rotated. There are some functions like rotating the table is removed, streamlined. I guess that has something to do how you design a module, and then you can quickly do your stuff here. Yeah. Yeah, here you have some areas, also very small, very good. Yeah, you can also go full screen with the Alt Enter thing, then you even have more screen. And you can also go widescreen to stretch the screen. It crashed while doing that. Let's try it now. Yeah, sometimes the module does strange stuff indeed. Should be telling don't. Ah, I'm already widescreen, okay. Ah, true, that the original is 4:3. Okay, yeah, that's crazy. Yeah, no, we will use widescreen definitely. Even though that is not widescreen, but yeah, so there might be not the best widescreen support going on. That could be also a thing. And full screen, that thing is sometimes a bit. What else, yeah? Good, yeah, you have here the counters, for example, which you need. There is also a hand function that is also nice, where you can put stuff into your hand. It is also minimizing if you want to select your submarine. Maybe the type 7 is selected, or select torpedoes. You can bring them here to your hand. And there's also this selection function, which you then can bring over and place them on your submarine. I mean, all submarines are loaded with torpedoes, so that is not required. You can also pin the hand if you don't like this. It's sometimes annoying when you have elements that always pop up down. You might want to pin it so we get rid of the hand. So it seems like we don't require it here. Everything that you need is on the map. Yeah, this you can use to take a closer look as so. Ah, okay. Mostly we can move those elements. It also doesn't have this somewhat complicated Vasal hotkeys. Like if you simply want to delete something, you press delete. Yeah, in Vasal you need, I don't know, what was it, control delete for whatever reason. Why? Yeah? Why control delete? If I want to delete something, I press delete, yeah, period. I mean, there's definitely reasons for that, but it is sometimes really this Glocknut overcomplicated, which can sometimes make Vasal very annoying. It's really, you notice that sometimes it is designed for or by people that when it comes to time efficiency, interface efficiency, yeah, no. Good. Yeah, we won't play it now. I just wanted to showcase it. You keep that video rather short. You would do stuff. Yeah, exactly. Here. Dice. Double click and he's throwing them. Yeah, somewhat similar to a. I would like to print it out. Yeah, that I prefer the Vasal printout, because it is the fastest. I want instant, but I think there was a setting for that. So I really don't care that much for this, but others care. They like this exciting rolling around there, like on a table. Because he's also withdrawing them. While I still struggle to do the math. I mean, you see it here? Sure, okay. But I'm pretty sure that can be set. There are some settings that you can use to customize it. Yeah, video capture, I think. Good. A lot of stuff nowadays shouldn't be that hard anymore, yeah, but. Yeah, not sure, but it is rather streamlined, yeah, so, but it's okay, it's fine. I would also prefer that the dice roll out while showing you the numbers horizontal. That's, I'm not a fan of that, I mean, but they really go for the real experience. You can do basically those, they roll around, but the eyes always show on a horizontal. Then it's easier to read instead of this jumping around left right. Yeah, but it's okay. That is here for find that unnecessary. But okay. Yeah, you can, of course, as far as I'm aware, not maintain multiple screens here. Somewhat same limitation as with Tabletop Simulator. But that is a big advantage with Vasal, that you can have multi-screens while having, for example, rules open on the right. Perhaps there is a way to achieve that, but it's definitely a bit more complex than in Vasal, where you can basically use it like Windows interfaces. But yeah, here you're supposed, I guess, to jump around. That can be sometimes a bit annoying. I'm not sure if I would play rather here. I mean, if I'm aware with the rules, if I'm aware of the rules pretty good, I would don't mind to play here in this. If I would learn a game, I might rather stick with Vasal. So that might be also a difference. I think learning games and something like this or Tabletop Simulator might be a bit more difficult, especially if you have only one screen present. If you want to learn and play on the same screen, then you can achieve that. Rebuild a training regime with Vasal. Here, I mean, sure, you can also do that, especially because it is like the board game experience. Perhaps you like that, packing out, laying everything and then looking around, finding the information. Yeah, so that should give you an idea. Check out if your module is present there. It is free, try it out. There's also a manual on the webpage. And yeah. See you in the next episode.